And welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity, Blind. I'm the RPG Chick. We have just left Leia Remen, if I'm saying that correctly. Gone to the dungeon the last two episodes, and now the way out on the other side leads down to this unexplored area of Stormwall Gorge. So,
got it.
Let's explore. I'm not sure what we'll find down here. I mean, this area was covered with water before. I guess the water was emptying into that cavern or dungeon. Hello? She arrives at last. She does. Leaden Key Wizard, we've been looking for you. Well, well, well. A woman in robes, flanked by an armed group, savors every word before whispering the next. Finally. You should have remained in Defiance Bay. She draws a smile, pale and full, that droops below her recessed chin. But I'm glad you didn't have better sense. I've looked forward to this since you got in our way. Have you now? Leaden Key Chanter says, it's her, the other one. A woman in the group motions with her arquebus toward Palagina. Weren't we looking for her, too? Yes. She squints and looks Palagina up and down. A dark-skinned woman with feathers. There can't be too many of your kind around these parts, can there? She smiles with strange geniality. Palagina's feathers ruffle, and the golden irises of her eyes grow thin, swallowed by the blackness of her widening pupils. And why would you be looking for me, Amika? The same reason I'm looking for her. The woman's eyes twinkle above her placid smile. You should know, little bird. No one wants to hear songs about conspiracies. Her voice deepens and takes on an edge of menace. It just makes us want to wring your neck. Any last words? After all the effort you've mustered, it'd be a shame to end it quietly. Aggressive. Well, the aggressive and number 5 are both threatening. I'm not cruel. Well, I don't think either 2 or 5 will have a bearing. We're gonna fight them no matter what, right? But let's go with 2. Haven't you heard what I do to my enemies? Surrender, unless you want a taste of my anger. The complacent smile on the woman's lips vanishes. You! She gives a sideways glance to her henchmen. Yes, I've heard. Leaden Key Fighter. A corpulent man, muscled beneath rolls of fat, snaps his head in the woman's direction. I've heard it too. Kills without thinking twice, this one. The jowls under his chin quiver as he spits the words out. By the flame nailed, let it go. Shut up, the command whistles through her clenched teeth. Leaden Key Rogue. A cowled man, cleaning his fingernails with the point of a long stiletto, doesn't let the silence last. I told you he had too big a mouth, boss. He spreads his fingers apart and gives them a good look. But if the oaf's got it right, I'm not here to die for nothing. Are we actually going to have an impact on this other than just fighting them anyway? The woman's shoulders drop. Winds take you. At what point did I promise an easy job? She stares at the ground, her lips hanging down like ripe fruits. Her lips hanging down. How do I know you'll spare us if I give up? Have I stood by my word? Is that the first time I've shown mercy? Give you a chance, make your choice. You don't, Panish ran out. Patience ran out, time for me to kill and for you to die. Patience ran out. God, I hate when that happens. My patience runs out. Should we kill them? I mean, they're the leaden key. I could kill them anyway. I don't know if we can take them in. Maybe we can put them in our prison. That would be ideal. If we can put them in our prison or bring them back to Defiance Bay or something like that and turn them in. This way they can, you know... I don't know, they can get more information from them. However, whichever way they want to do it. I've always stood by my word. The fighter says, that was the rumor too, before you hired us. In the gift. The fighter hammers his fat finger against his temple. I remember, I do. Is he talking to Theodas, or is he talking to the wizard? He's talking to us. We hired them? I mean, probably. We had a number of quests. I don't remember. The woman bites on her lower lip, flushing it red, and she shakes her head. Whitaker, have mercy. She locks eyes on you. Take me away. Anywhere. Anywhere is better than here. Ah, well, they got away. Okay. That was interesting. We don't have a quest update. I didn't see anything go on. I don't know, we're not updated. That's so funny. That's...
Be cautious. Be constant.
Funny as in... odd. Alright, well, we'll continue exploring. I mean, what else can we do? Maybe I should just kill them all. I thought maybe we'd turn them in, but they teleported away. They might be back to, darken our doorstep, I think. Oh, a Stelgare! First time ever? Stelgare? We've heard a lot about them. Gotta fight our first Stelgare, guys. See how bad these things are.
Yes?
See how many of them there are. Look at that thing. There's a bunch. There's three. Gonna need that sword. Yeah, they're pretty quick, these things. Soul ignition on this guy.
I'm ready.
Oh, we got rid of one already? Not bad. Being there on four legs, I'm not sure if we can knock them down. And there's another one coming, of course. blessing.
Hey.
Ooh, yeah, they're not bad at all. Okay. Are you attacking a dare? He wasn't doing anything. They're not hard at all. Stelgar Hide. Stelgar feature in a host of Glamfellen stories, respected as top predators and valued as formidable companions for those able to tame the creatures. Many adherents of Galloway see Stelgar as the ultimate prey, for the great cats can just as easily turn the tide of a hunt and kill... those foolhardy or brave enough to seek them out. Stelgar hides decorate the homes of many Glamfellen leaders, and the large fangs of elder lions serve as symbols of strength and honor. You know, after hearing so much about them, though, it's kind of anticlimactic that we killed them so easily. Should have even made them tougher, or should have introduced them to us earlier before we were so high in level. Oh well. See if it says anything else. Anything about them here. Crystal Eater Spiderling. Only this last paragraph, I guess, is about the Crystal Eater Spiderlings? Spiders? Seldom seen outside of the most remote locations in Ir Glamfath, the fabled crystal eaters are enormous and powerful, possessing magical abilities some wizards believe have been developed through the consumption of Adra and enchanted gemstones. In addition to their ability to raise a field of deadly crystal spikes, the venom of a crystal eater will temporarily turn a victim's flesh and blood to stone. Subsequent attacks by the crystal eater on a petrified foe are quickly fatal. Have I read this? The Lemgen? I've only defeated one of them. The Dilemgen are forest spirits of Ir Glamfath that are bound into ancient, often petrified trees or Adra monuments. They appear to have mostly elven-shaped bodies, but their skin is made of wood and their hair is long and plant-like. Adragans appear to have skin made of Adra. Dilemgen glow slightly and often have tiny motes of light around them. They do not wear clothes, but lack sexual organs, as they only have the overall shape of humanoids. Dilemgen are entirely magical beings and do not use physical weapons to attack. Their attractiveness is used in tandem with their magic, typically to stop attackers or lure them to their deaths. These creatures draw their essence from the environments. While they have physical bodies and can be killed if those bodies are destroyed, their survival also depends on the health of their environment. They feel no natural animosity towards other beings, but they will defend their territories fiercely. Thus Dilemga and Adragan, Adra-born, may individually be more or less hostile depending on the well-being of their locale, and on whether other explorers or adventurers have in the past proved dangerous or benign. They are a natural roadblock to large-scale development. While rural tribes in Ir Glamfath often live peacefully alongside them, expanding or developing cities and towns may find themselves beset by hostile Dilemgen. Some kith, too, oppose the destruction of Dilemgen habitats. City dwellers generally support the notion, believing that their souls will simply reincarnate in other forests or back into kith. Dilemgen are traditionally friendly toward rangers and druids. Their spiritual link with trees has led to greater understanding of the link between rangers and their animal companions, though a definitive connection has yet to be made. Dargul? I don't remember reading these, so I'll just read these really quick. Dargul's have reached the first irreversible step in the decay of anomaly dead body sustained by soul energy. At this stage, they have lost some portion of their memories and mental abilities, but they retain the self-awareness to recognize their own decline. Their insatiable hunger and inevitable decay make Dargools more reckless and aggressive than vampires, even as they are compelled to seek out secret and secluded environments so as to avoid drawing the attention and wrath of civilized communities. Some vampires dread this stage more than those that follow, for they know that they will retain enough of their faculties to fully experience their own downfall. Alright, hold on 1 second. The room is getting warm. I must remove a layer of clothing here. Blah. Alright, what else we got? Menpogra. Right. We just defeated that first thing, right? Adelimpogra, Rotten Leith, more typically called Pogra, Rotten, is a Dilemkin that has been corrupted by the destruction of their home tree or address stone. They are as ugly as Dilemkin are beautiful, spindly and emaciated with cool tones to their skin. Their hair is dark, dead dark and slimy, their facial features contorted, and their teeth long and sharp. Unlike Dilemkin, they are not surrounded by motes of light, and they are more than willing to attack unfortunate travelers with their long talons. Pogra decorate themselves with the skull, skins, and feathers of animals they've killed. Just as Dilemkin seek to maintain the health of their forests, Pogra seek to corrupt them, making the two species mortal enemies. The rot that infects them endows their attacks with a ghastly poison, but it also makes their bodies weak and brittle, leaving them vulnerable to piercing and crushing attacks. Since they can no longer draw essence from a healthy forest, they must survive by drawing energy and essence out of plants, animals, and kith. This makes them natural allies with shadows, which feed by similar means and enjoy the benefits of a shared hunt. They are hostile toward all life, but rangers and druids are their most common foes. Ogre Matron. We got a separate one for Ogre Matron? Yeah, I've read about this is the same general description of Ogre. Pogra. This is the same that I just read. Stelgar. Stelgars are large predatory cats. While juveniles are often lone hunters, mature Stelgars will often band together in prides to defend territory, hunt prey, and care for their young. These cats are aggressive and highly adaptable, and particular strains of this species may be found in a range of environments from hot plants to frozen tundra. Kith settlements have pushed them out of most of the territory around Defiance Bay. As a result, they are more common in Ir Glanfath. Their status as a deadly predator makes them a noteworthy trophy among followers of Galloween. General Ooze description. What? Done.
I shall be discreet.
Okay, so we can look at the wall here. Moss has taken root in the damp stone. So it has. So if this is covered by water, where are all these Stelgar? Were they just swimming all this time?
Yes?
Bidoki! That's it. Let's see how well they burn. Everyone, go here, except for you, go here. No problem at all. Poor things, didn't stand a chance. Stelgar tooth. Though not one of the large fangs for which Stelgars are famed, this sharp tooth is nonetheless impressive.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea.
Let's double back.
Which is not very quiet.
Oh, see, I want to explore this whole area here, so I don't miss stuff like this. More like her. A small horn helm, an egg, and 3 silver. Why we're sneaking if it's just Stelgar. Should rest soon. Skein bone. More.
Following your lead.
Not gonna be able to see them through the trees. Only one? When do we get one of these large fangs? Don't they have them?
Nice and quiet.
I'm surprised there was only one that time. Ah, his friends didn't join in. I'm always checking him, just in case.
Following your lead.
So easy.
My eyes are peep.
Oh my god. We're killing them solo. Why isn't two of them this time? Oh my god! He didn't even get to us. Things are doomed.
That's it.
I remember how hard it was to fight a lion the first time. This is nothing in comparison.
And what does the flame reveal?
Stuff. Maybe. Head down south. I'm gonna clear out all this fog. See all that there is to see. Kill all that is to be killed. Oh, a dank spore. I'm starting to get tired.
Following your lead.
We're almost done with this zone. You missed! Almost dead. Missed again.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea, which is...
A lizard scurries under the rock. Okay.
Not very quiet.
It's two of them. Oh, it turned her evil. Best thing to do is to get her away from her when she does that. Or when one of us does that. Oh, we didn't get far. Oh, he turned evil too. That's not good. Almost dead, the swamp slime? Yep. Dead. Okay.
I have them!
Oh, canna. Oh, couldn't be. Hold on. I thought we had melee equipment. Chunkage. Oozes and crap. No, I'm trying to hit this.
My eyes are peeled.
Well, I probably should hit that, but I don't know. We're not having any problem right now. I just want to explore the south. The southwards area here. Is that... that's a lizard thing? Okay. Oh wait, there's a little bit more. I'm so picky when it comes to this. Alright, good.
Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.
Words to live by. Water. We're in water, right? No, it's just a shadow. Okay. Moss has taken root in the damp stone. We've been here. No, not really. This is where we were. We couldn't go any further. we are done with this zone. We done killed everything. It's camp. I don't know what we're gonna meet next. Besides daylight. Ooh, Elm Shore. Elm Shore. Okay. Stay tuned for next episode, guys, when we explore Elm Shore. Which... Hearthsong might be next, or maybe Burial Isle? In the water? Thanks for watching, see you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.